In your project charter, you stipulated a baseline condition as part of your key metric. Under the measure phase, you'll expand that, and you'll expand it in one or more of the three tools that are provided here. Possibly the most powerful is behavior charts and process capability. Not to be overlooked is Pareto analysis, which is a simple and powerful tool. And finally, if you want to express the quality of your process in sigmas, you can do that with the sigma calculator. And I have preloaded that just to show you that if we test 1,000,000 units with one opportunity for a defect per unit, and we find 3.4 defects, we get, oddly, 3.4 defects per million opportunity, a sigma equivalent of 4.5 sigmas. Now, if you like the 1.5 sigma shift, that would then make 3.4 defects per million opportunities equal to a 6 sigma process. Let's just walk through one other example. Let's say that I've tested 1,000 units. Whoops, that's one too many zeros. And I've got 5 opportunities per defect. And let's take this out. Obviously, this really needs to be an integer. You don't find 4/10 of a defect. The math still works, but it doesn't happen in real life. And let's say that in those 1,000 units with 5 opportunities each, I found 4 defects. I would then find that I've got 0.003 defects per unit, DPU. That's a useful number. We've got 6 ten-thousandths, roughly, of a defect per opportunity, which is kind of awkward. Easier to express that as 680 defects per million opportunities, or DPMO. And then, depending on whether or not you like the 1.5 sigma shift, we've either got a 3.2 sigma process or a 4.66 sigma process.